Why are signs important?
Signs can help you know where you're at and where you're going.
And signs, they can help us find things that we desperately need.
Signs can keep us safe too. Stop signs help us not get in accidents.
So signs can give us really important information really quickly. Signs can keep us safe, and signs can help keep other people safe too, right? So last week, John taught us that Jesus is the light. The light for the paths that we're walking on, that helps keep us on that right path. Well, this week, John takes it a little bit further, and he gives us some signs to help us make sure that we are staying on that right path. Let's listen to the first one that he has for us. We know that we have come to know him if we keep his commands. Whoever says, "I know him," but does not do what he commands is a liar, and the truth is not in that person. Oh, that's kind of harsh, isn't it? I mean, John's saying that if we say that we know Jesus, but we don't do the things that he says, we're liars. We don't actually know Jesus. Well, think about it this way. We say Jesus is a lot of things. We say that Jesus is God. And so if we actually believe that, if we actually believe that Jesus is God, but we don't do the things that he tells us to do, are we acting like Jesus is God? Are we acting like he is all of those things? Are we acting like we actually take him seriously? Not really. So I think John's pointing out, first of all, that if we talk the talk, we should walk the walk, right? So obeying Jesus because he's God is a really good reason to obey him. But John goes a little bit further than that. John gives us another sign that I think ties right into that. Anyone who loves their brother and sister lives in the light, and there is nothing in them to make them stumble. You see, I think that ties right into obeying Jesus because Jesus said as much himself. In Matthew 22, Jesus tells us that the summary of all of the law is to love God and to love your neighbor. So what John's pointing out is that if we're loving the people that God has placed around us and we're loving God, we are obeying Jesus. You might be wondering how though. Okay, well, let's use the Ten Commandments as a guide. A good way to start loving someone is not murdering them, right? The farther and farther away you get from murder and hate, the closer and closer you get to loving that person. I mean, if you truly love someone, you're not going to kill them, right? Another good one is don't steal. Of course, right? Yeah, when I don't steal, I'm loving people. What? Well, maybe when we're not stealing, what we're actually saying is, hey, I love you more than I love your stuff. You see, we can work through all the commandments like this and see how when we follow them, we are loving God and we're loving the people around us. So seeing how not stealing can point us in the direction of loving our neighbors actually kind of starts getting us along the way to seeing the last thing that John has for us. You see, God meant us for so much more than what the world tries to tell us. God meant us for loving people and not things. God meant us for loving people and not hurting them or squashing them by trying to build ourselves up. I think that's why John wrote this. Do not love this world or the things it offers you. For when you love the world, you do not have the love of the Father in you. For the world offers only a craving for physical pleasure, a craving for everything we see, and pride in our achievements and possessions. These are not from the Father, but are from the world. So I think John really wants to encourage us to listen to Jesus. Well, A, because he's God, but B, because the things that Jesus commands us are good for us, like the stop sign that we saw at the beginning. You see, because when we listen to Jesus, when we follow him, when we do what he says, we're loving him better and we're loving the people around us better. And we're getting a little bit closer to what God always intended for us. Loving people, not hating them, not hurting them or squashing them or putting them down, loving them and loving God. So yeah, when we talk the talk, we should walk the walk. Today, we learned that we should listen to Jesus. Because when we do, we're walking in the light. But also, when we listen to Jesus and do what he says, we're loving the people around us. And we're starting to live and love a bit more like Jesus. When we're starting to get a little bit closer to what God always intended for us. Let's talk to him now. Dear Jesus, help us to listen to you and follow you. Help us to grow in love for you and for the people you've put in our lives. Jesus, forgive us when we don't. Forgive us when we go our own way. Bring us back to your way and help us stay in it. We pray this and the prayer that you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us for our online family worship. If you'd like to hear more about this, about listening to Jesus, or the whole letter of 1 John in general, please check out Pastor's message here on our channel. Have a great week, everybody.